In this Photoshop tutorial, I'm going to show you a brand new feature, which is multi-image content aware fill. Now, this is only available in the beta. I'm going to show you how to get the beta at the end of this tutorial, which anyone can. So if we look at this ferry that I shot up in the Pacific Northwest, we can see we've got these areas we want to remove. Now, if I was going to remove these for content aware fill, let me quickly show you what kind of result we would get. I'm just going to hit the shift delete, and this is regular content aware. Sort of does a good job on the left, but on the right, it doesn't know what to put in there. So in order to fix this, we need to find an image that shows this part. So this other image has the area that we want. Now, in the past, you would cut that and then you would paste it in here and try to get it to fit. Let me show you how to use this new feature. So we're going to make a selection around these areas we want to remove. So let's grab our object selection tool and just drag around the first one. Let's hold the shift key, drag around the second one. And this makes a selection around these two areas. Let's expand our selection a little bit. Select, modify, expand. 5 pixels should be fine. Great. Now we're going to go under the edit, and under edit, choose content aware fill. Now this will show the result it's going to get over here. This is actually better than what we got before on the left-hand side. It's not bad, but the front of the boat still looks like a mangled mess. So here's the new feature. We're going to choose additional document, click, and we're going to import. So let's find the other image and click open. And as you can see, it does a pretty good job in this image, but that's not always the case. Let me just apply this and I'll show you another example. Let me show you some other features that are available to help us fix it when it doesn't give us the result we want. So first of all, let's make a selection around the area that we want to content aware fill. So let's choose edit, content aware fill. Now, obviously this is not working too well. We're missing the whole part of the tail. So let's grab the additional document and we're going to import. And click OK. So as you can see, it's not working very well there. We're going to now use the alignment tool. So see this little pin? We're going to choose this pin. So we're going to guide it by using this pin. So we've added the first pin. Let's add a second one over here near where the tail would be. Maybe a third one over here on the legs. And sometimes you'll get these little warnings. Don't worry about it. We can add 4 points. And then what we're going to do is we're going to make sure they align. So we've got point number one. Let's go to the bottom image. And we can see there it is. So let's drag it up here. Now remember, this is beta, so it's not finished or complete yet. So expect it not to work perfectly all the time. Let's drag number two into position. Number three, let's put that around the leg. So we're obviously going to have some issues with their leg misaligning here too. And let's grab number four. Now, if we look on our image, you can see that it's actually done a much better job of aligning this. Okay, at this point, it's looking pretty good. The colors are off a little bit. And I'll be honest with you, these colors are not working too well at the moment. So it's probably easier to use other ways to fix these colors. We're just going to click OK. And we can see that we've got a new layer here, so we can mask that out and we can make it a lot more perfect. But as you can see, it saves a lot of time working this way. Oh, and in case you're worrying about this color, here's the quickest way to get rid of that. Just create a new layer. Change it to color blend mode. Grab a brush. Hold down the Alt or the Option key, sample the color. And then just paint. And that's a fast way to get rid of the color cast. Now let me show you how to get the beta. So what you're going to do is you're going to go into your Creative Cloud account. And under your Creative Cloud account, you're going to see an option here that says Beta Apps. And then under Beta Apps, we can download the Photoshop beta right there. So this is the public beta that has some new features inside of Photoshop for you to play around with. Now, here's something really important. When you start to use these new features, it's really important to give Adobe feedback. this feedback could determine whether these features make it into the final version of Photoshop or not. So what you want to do is see this little icon up the top here. Click on there and we'll see features to review, and these are the features. And you can report a bug, submit an idea, or visit the beta community. So I encourage you to go in here to the beta community here and provide some feedback on these features. Now, I can assure you the product managers are actually paying a lot of attention to what you're saying here. So this is your chance to have some real input into the development of Photoshop. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Drop a comment. Let me know if you found this useful. And let me know if you guys are already on the beta and if you're enjoying it or not. And by the way, the beta will run side by side with your original version of Photoshop, so you don't have to uninstall or replace your version of Photoshop. So anyway, if you're new, hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my tutorials. Do me a favor, hit the thumbs up, that's the like button. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.